తీరునివాసాయ పండరీపురవాసిని పాండురంగ ప్రకాశాయ విఠలాయ నమో నమః మరుత్పుత్రాయ కవయే భీమాయ భయహారిణే శ్రీమదానంద తీర్థాయ ప్రఖ్యాతాయ నమో నమః శివతనయ వరిష్టం సర్వకళ్యాణమూర్తిం పరశుకమలహస్తం శోభితం మోదకేన అరుణకుసుమమాలా వ్యాలలంబోదరం తం మమ హృదయ నివాసం శ్రీగణేశం నమామి కృష్ణవ్రతా కృష్ణమనుస్మరంత రాత్రౌ చ కృష్ణం పునరుత్థితాయై తే కృష్ణదేహా ప్రవిశంతి కృష్ణం ఆజ్యం యథా మంత్రహుతం హుతాశీ బుద్ధిర్బలం యశోధైర్యం నిర్భయత్వమరోగత అజాఢ్యం వాక్పటుత్వం చ హనుమత్స్మరణాత్ భవేత్ చిత్రైపదైశ్చ గంభీరై వాక్యమానైరఖండితై గురుభావం వ్యంజయంతి భాతి శ్రీ జయతీర్థవాక్ ప్రణమత్కామధేనుం చ భజత్సురతరూపమం శ్రీభావబోధకృత్పాద చింతామణిముపాస్మహే పూజ్యాయ రాఘవేంద్రాయ సత్యధర్మరతాయ చ భజతాం కల్పవృక్షాయ నమతాం కామధేనుభి అన్నపూర్ణే సదా పూర్ణే శంకర ప్రాణవల్లభే జ్ఞానవైరాగ్య సిద్ధ్యర్థం భిక్షాం దేహీ చ పార్వతీ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవేతి యో వదేత్ తస్య నిస్సరతే వాణీ జన్ను కన్యా ప్రవాహవత్ రాకాచంద్ర సమాన కాంతివదన నాకాధిరాజస్తుత మూకానామపి కురువతి సురధునీ నీకాశ వాక్వైభవం శ్రీకాంక్షీనగరి విహారరసికా శోకాపహంత్రీ సతాం ఏకా పుణ్యపరంపరా పశుపతే ఆకారిణీ రాజతే సత్యం విధాతుం నిజవృత్యభాషితం వ్యాప్తిం చ భూతేషు అఖిలేషు చాత్మనః అదృశ్యత అత్యద్భుత రూపముద్వహన్ తం భే సభాయాం న మృగం న మానుషం నరసింహ న మృగం న మానుషం సంసార సాగరే మగ్నం భాగవతాఖ్యోయం ప్రత్యక్ష కృష్ణయేవ హి స్వీకృతోసి మయానాథ ముక్త్యర్థం భవసాగరే మనోరథో మదీయోయం సఫల సర్వథా త్వయా నిర్విఘ్నేనైవ కర్తవ్యో దాసోహం తవ కేశవ శుకరూపా ప్రబోధజ్ఞా సర్వశాస్త్ర విశారదా ఏతత్కథా ప్రకాశేన మదజ్ఞానం వినాశయా వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం.
That is how ego is. Again, there's a trace of ego. That ego trace tells him, I will fight my battle alone. Self-confidence. Blah, blah. I have got my self-confidence, my degrees, my experience, my proficiency. You are nothing. When calamity strikes, calamity is like a mountain crushing a squirrel. Then you say, oh God, I can't bear it anymore. I can't bear it anymore. What is the way out? Someone said there is a God. I don't know his name. I never prayed to him. His email ID, I don't know. His phone number, I don't know. His form, I don't know. His qualities, I don't know. But I've heard that he is the master of the world. Oh God, if you're there, listen to me. Listen to me. Desperate Gajendra calling out in a lonely valley, caught in the pool of life. Life is so difficult sometimes that without the help of God, you cannot move on. That is why before you become desperate, chant the name of the Lord. And the Lord is there. There is no doubt about it. He is there. He is asking, you who create the world, sustain the world, destroy the world, I bow down to you. From whom the world comes, into whom the world goes, by whom the world is sustained, I bow down to you. You are the cause of the world. The causeless cause of the world. I bow down to you. Namo namaste akhila karanaya, nishkaranaya, adbhuta karanaya, wonderful cause of the world. The Nobel Prize people who have been given the Nobel Prize in physics, three of them had discovered a particle. Not knowing what to call it, they call it God's particle. Please give them big. Namo namaste. Akhila karanaya, nishkaranaya, adbhuta karanaya. They don't know how to explain it, so they call it God's particle. It has to be. There must be some inexplicable mystery. Call it by any name you want. But we call him Krishna. We call him Narayana. This is how he's calling out to the Lord and calls out for a long time. There's no response. No response. Everything is quiet. The Lord is only testing. Patience is a quality of faith. Patience and faith are two sides of the same coin. If you have faith, you must have patience. Sometimes my mother, when I used to suffer a lot, said, how much patience do you have? I said, I don't know, Amma. But I know good days will come. I know good days will come. I know things will be better than before. And when things did happen that way, she said, now I know this is the result of patience. Be patient, my dear listeners. You want everything the fast track. How can you have it? You have to wait. You have to wait to have the Lord's grace. And once you have patience, the Lord loves you for patience. That is what sahishnuta, forbearance, is the quality of faith. And now he's asking the Lord, I called out so many times and you have not come. What is the quality which I shall praise, which will move you? Then he remembers that there is a beautiful aspect of the Lord called grace. Grace is the language of the Lord in response to the call of prayer. Grace is the answer to the call of prayer. So he is telling the Lord, there's a speed of sound. Faster than the speed of sound is the speed of light. Faster than the speed of light is the speed of the mind. Your mind must be thinking of your son or daughter in New York or Bahrain or Singapore or Malaysia. Mind has gone there 1 minute to tell the child about the Bhagavatam. In 1 minute, the mind can go. No need for my clear trip. The mind can travel wherever it wants. But then he says, faster than the mind is the speed of grace, my dear listener, the speed of grace. When Krishna wants to help you, it is overnight, overnight, overnight. It happens in a trice. Before you can wink, the miracle has taken place. You can't evaluate the speed of grace. The Bhagavata says, Namo namastubhyam asakhya vega, shakti trayaya akhiladhi gunaya, prapanna palaya duranta shaktaye, kadindriyanam anavapya vartmane. And then when he looks, you know, when a big person, bulky, great in life, is falling, It's terrible to see him. Terrible to see a big man fall. And he's crying. Small eyes, large body, looking here and there, everywhere. No answer to my prayers. The pool of water and then the river flowing. The silent valleys and the silent skies. No response. A hushed silence is overbearing. And he's looking up. For me, this video of Gajendra is unforgettable. Will he come? Will he come? Rabindranath Tagore says, he comes, he comes, he forever comes. And I say, he cares, he forever cares. He came in the past, he comes in the present, and he'll come in the future too. Suddenly he sees one small little, that's the video, sir. Bird comes flying. Is it a sparrow? No, no, no. It's the king of birds. It is Garuda that is coming. Oh God, it's not Garuda alone. I see the Pitambara, I see the Makuta, I see the Kundala, I see the Urdhva Tilaka. He's got a chakra in hand. My Lord Narayana has come. I called him Mr. X. I now see his identity. May the Lord come and protect me. Tam tatpadartham upalabhyar jagan nivasa totram nishamya vidivijay sahasam tuvadbihi chandomayena garudena samuhyamanaha chakrayudho abhyagamat ashoyato gajendraha. Potana says he abandons Mother Lakshmi. Even his Uttariya gets entangled with her sari pallu, and he leaves the Uttariya and comes running because his bhakta Gajendra is calling. And when he comes, Gajendra says, I have nothing to offer you, master, except the lotus of my heart, my lord. The lotus of my heart. Sontasarasi uruvalena grihita artho drishtva garutmati harimkha upatta chakram utkshipya sambujakaram giramah krishnat narayana akhila guru Bhagavan namaste, 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 Narayana namaste, Akhila Guru namaste, Bhagavan namaste, namaste. You have come for a creature, Swami. A creature who forgot you for years together. A creature who lived oblivious of your divinity and your grace. One who was heady, one who was so full of pride. You came for him, my Lord, you came for him. Namaste, namaste, namaste. This head has never bowed down to you. I bang my head before you. Accept this lotus. From that day till this day, the Lord is holding the lotus in, Guruvayur says, Bhattadri, because it has been given by the great bhakta called Gajendra. He had a chakra in hand. He cut off the head of the crocodile. There was an objection among Alvars. The Alvars are having a debate. One Alvar said, objection. Why? What's the problem? Oh, it was Gajendra who prayed and it was the crocodile who got moksha. The other Alvar said, you don't understand. Before the bhakta gets moksha, the one who holds the feet of the bhakta gets moksha. Please remember that. That is the order of moksha. That is the order of liberation. Padvritya vritya paricharaka vritya vritya vrityasya vritya iti mam smara lokanatha. My dear listeners, who was this Gajendra? How did he pray? Prayer doesn't come overnight. My non-Hindu friend asked me, why do you believe in rebirth? I said, because one semester is not enough. The Lord says, Bahunam Janmanam Ante Jnanavanmam Prabhajyate Vasudeva Sarvamiti Samahatma Sudurlabha. After several Janmas, little by little I improve my grids. And finally I reach the Lord. In his past birth, he was a Dravida king called Indradyumna. Our problem was his problem. We also do puja. You ask people, what do you do in Navratri? I do this padam and that padam and this scripture and that temple visit and this puja and this dana. We love to talk about our spiritual achievements. Spiritual achievements should be as secret as your bank balance. You understand? You can reveal your bank balance, but don't reveal your spiritual experiences. Don't talk about it. Here is Indradyumna, very proud of doing puja. For hours together, he used to do puja. And there came the saint called Agastya. I always imagine, if Durvasa or Vishwamitra had come, he would have been burnt alive. It was Agastya, that peace-loving, short little sage who can drink the seven seas water. That Agastya, the famous one who gave us the Adityatriya Stotram in the Valmiki Ramayana. Quiet fellow. He is sitting and waiting for Indradyumna to finish puja. And Indradyumna continues for hours together. Finally, Agastya gets tired and says, may you become an elephant in your next birth. He became an elephant, but he did not forget the sadhana that he had done, my dear listeners. That is how he could praise the Lord. Narayana Akhila Guru Bhagavan Namaste Namo Namaste Akhila Karanaya Nishkaranaya Adbhuta Karanaya. You think an ordinary elephant can praise the Lord like that? It was because of the spiritual bank balance that he had. And now, this particular episode is very dear to sannyasins. Whenever I do the katha in Haridwar, Rishikesh, Vrindavan, Kashi, I know that sannyasins will come and listen to this episode. Why? Because of the Phalashruti. Every episode in the Bhagavatam has a fruit. A lovely fruit is given to you at the end of every episode. Do you know that the fruit for this episode is given by Narayana himself? Clap for him. Lord Narayana himself tells Gajendra, he who listens to your charitra and mine, he who thinks of the Panchajanya, he who thinks of the Garuda, he who thinks of all the lovely bhaktas like Prahlada, at the time of their departure from the world, last moment, I will give them clear thinking. Ye maam stuvantya nenanga pratibuddhya nishatyaye tesham pranatyaye chaham dadami vimalam matim. Dadami vimalam matim. I give them clear mind to think about me. Many of you have not heard my Bhagavatam. For those who have heard, they will bear with the repetition. Very difficult to chant the name of the Lord. Hari Hari Analike Bahala Kathina Swami. The Dasas say, very difficult to chant the name of the Lord. One day I was taken to the cancer hospital in Madras, where an elderly person was departing from the world. The doctor gave me special permission because I was a preacher. I thought I'll go and ask the gentleman, very old man. I said, sir, mama, how are you feeling? Painful. I'm going to depart from the world. I said, no, don't say that. And then I said, put your head on my shoulder. And slowly I was stroking his head. I said, please chant Narayana. He got angry with me. No, I won't chant. I thought I was a clever lawyer. I said, what will you not chant? You understand? If I say, what will you not chant? He will say, I will not chant Narayana. Incidentally, he will chant Narayana. But his karma was more powerful. He said, I won't chant that which you are chanting. This is the logic of sin. What can you do? Diabolic sin. Sin can be diabolic. It can make you go mad. Hari Hari Analike Bahala Kathina Swami Sriman Narayan Narayan Narayan.
Sriman Narayan Narayan.
Sriman Narayan Narayan Hari Hari.
Tere Mahima Sabse
Nyari Nyari.
Hari Hari. Tere Mahima Sabse Nyari Nyari.
Hari Hari.
Sriman Narayan Narayan
Hari Hari.
Sriman Narayan Narayan.
Hari Om Namo Narayana Sriman Narayana Narayana Hari Hari. My dear listeners, you'll have to bear with me because as per traditional rules, we have to go on to the episode of Shri Krishna's advent. the eighth chapter has an important episode of Vamanavatara. In the ninth canto, you have the advent of Sri Rama. References made in a brief way to the master of the world who comes as Sri Rama. And we know that Rama is Sharanagata Vatsala. So one little snippet of a song on Sri Rama.
Sharanagata Vatsala Ram ki ye punya amar hai kahani.
Sharanagata Vatsala Ram ki ye punya amar hai kahani.
Jo se sune aur sunaye.
Jo se sune aur sunaye.
Raghuvar ko wo khub hi bhaye.
Raghuvar ko wo khub hi bhaye.
Aankh mein bhar aaye paani.
Aankh mein bhar aaye paani.
Sharanagat Vatsal Ram ki ye punya amar hai kahani.
We come to the 10th canto. The 10th canto has 90 chapters and it is about Krishna. Among the Puranas, Bhagavata is the crown jewel, the crest jewel. Among the chapters of the Bhagavata, the Dashama Skanda is the crest jewel. We have come to the history of Krishna. When you look at the personality of Krishna, you are fascinated. There are some people who are beautiful. There are some people who sing beautiful. There are some people who walk beautiful. There are some people who dance beautiful. There are some people who think beautiful. Madhuradipater akhilam madhuram.
Adharam madhuram vadanam madhuram.
Adharam.
Adharam madhuram vadanam madhuram.
Adharam madhuram vadanam madhuram.
Nayanam madhuram hasitam madhuram.
Nayanam madhuram hasitam madhuram.
Hridayam madhuram gamanam madhuram. Hridayam
madhuram gamanam madhuram.
Madhuradhipate rakhilam madhuram. Madhuradhipate akhilam madhuram. Madhuradhipate akhilam madhuram. Madhuradhipate akhilam madhuram. Madhuradhipater akhilam madhuram.
Everything about him is beautiful. Everything about him is beautiful. And he's one of the most fascinating personalities. I have no problem with Sri Rama. But you can't approach Sri Rama or touch him. There, my father used to say, those who are accessible are not great, and those who are great are not accessible. Krishna was both, my dear listeners. He was accessible and he was great. Arjuna could say, hi Krishna, hi Madhava, and yet he could see that beautiful cosmic vision with 100,000 hands and 100,000 faces. That is the enigmatic personality of Sri Krishna. We know Sri Rama knew all the fine arts. Can you ask Rama to dance on a serpent? Can you ask Rama to play on the flute? No. But he is Sakalakala Adiguru Nanartha. Everything about him is strange. Everything about him is awesome. That is how he comes into the world. And when he comes into the world, Parikshit is asking, I want his history. Whose history? That Krishna. Which Krishna? Whom I saw in my mother's womb. When I was growing in my mother's womb, my mother went and asked the Lord for protection. Dravnyatra viplushtam idam madangam santana bijam kuru pandavanam jugopa kukshingata atta chakro matuschame yasharanangataya. My mother, freshly widowed, did not want to lose me. And she asked the Lord, Pahi Pahi Mahayogin Deva Deva Jagatpate, you took away my husband Abhimanyu, but don't take away this little one that's growing in my womb. Let me not have a miscarriage. This is what she asked him. And my Lord entered my mother's womb. Kukshingata Atta Chakru. I want that Krishna. That Krishna's history. You love him so much? I love him so much because it's a prenatal bond. Are you not hungry? Are you not thirsty? Why? That hunger and thirst which made Parikshit commit the sin of putting a dead snake round the neck of the seated sage, that hunger and thirst are now conquered in the 10th chapter, my dear listeners.